when we talk about this whole question of can an activist media be responsible, we should also talk about this true blue media companies and who have shown activism every now and then and who, as you say, have been by and large responsible. So is there possibly there is a way to be activist, to be activistic and be responsible or not?
Of course there is. I mean, that's what I'd call good journalism, as Shekhar said, active media rather than activist media. I mean, there can be media which is, you know, just sleeping and carrying news, which news is now a commodity, right? So you need to have news which actually goes and penetrates things which are not known to people. So I think that's active media. It is not necessarily activist media. To me, means somebody with an agenda, like what the Sopari journalism, what Rajdeep is talking about. So I think it is definitely possible to be, and media is responsible. They may make mistakes, they must acknowledge their mistakes and move on. But by and large, media can be responsible and is responsible.
Rajdeep, here is my submission, that I think by and large, the Indian media is far too responsible. We are not talking about the fringe media that goes out to settle scores with its business rival. By and large, they're very, very responsible and dare I say, even timid most of the time. Because we are way too careful about not unsettling sentiments. We don't get into private lives of people, even if that affects their public life and their public conduct. And if anything, as a journalist, as an editor, I have felt that we are far too careful. What do you say to that?
You know, just take the way the topic has been framed, and I presume it has been framed at CII, because there's a belief today in corporate India
that we are
that the media in some way is irresponsible.
Correct.
That the media in some way is part of the problem. You know, that just as there are the same argument could be made, can activist courts be responsible? There's a feeling within a section of corporate India that the courts are intervening in every aspect of life. Similarly, there's a feeling that this media which is there is a pestilence. The fact is, we have to be a pest. We are the gorilla in the room. You know, let's be clear. You know, that role has to be played. The worry is, the flip of this is, can a pliant media be responsible? Because what a large section of people do want, who have vested interests, who are powerful, is a pliant media. I mean, I use the word Sopari journalism, so I'll take a patent for that, but I'll take a word that Shekhar has recently been using, which is crony journalism. There is a lot of crony journalism which also goes on in this country, you're right. I wouldn't call it timid. I do believe that the good thing about these 400 channels in their own way has created a manic situation, you know, where there is no place to hide anymore. So there's, you know, in a sense, this television revolution to that extent has been very useful in breaking some of the timidity that did exist. You know, when old journalists tell us about this activism, many of the journalists of 30 years ago were stenographers. Let's be honest, they went from one government department and took the handouts that were given from each ministry and were happy with it. Compared to that, I still believe, even if we are irresponsible, better to be this kind of hyperactive, irresponsible media than the previous generation of timid journalists. And now the worry is this crony journalism, where whether we like it or not, people are being asked to sort of almost character certificates are being given to us. You know, I'll end with this, which is that, you know, we were doing a debate on gas prices, and Yogendra Yadav of the Aam Aadmi Party, and someone whom I've known for 20 years because we've done surveys together and things like that, suddenly, and it's live TV, so you can't even stop the guy. So on live TV he says, you know, I never thought that you would do a debate on gas pricing. Aapka to channel Ambani ka channel hai, aur aap is channel par kar rahe hai. I want to congratulate you. You have shown great courage. Effectively, what he was doing was giving me a character certificate, and there's too much of this going around, that if you're not with us, then you're necessarily with the other side. And that is leading to a certain cronyism and a collusion in our journalism, which is more worrying. But overall, I actually believe, Uday, today compared to 30 years ago, I think today's journalists in that sense are far more willing to sort of explore boundaries that the previous generation did not.
Uday, Shekhar. Can I raise a question with you now? I mean, yes. It's a question that you have to answer on journalism.
Sure.
And that to me sort of underlines the difference between active journalism and activist journalism. And what happens when India's most successful entertainment channel catches hold of India's biggest film star to do journalism? And what happens if that film star then, using his clout as a star who everybody trusts, and the reach of your channel peddles falsehoods? I mean, do I have to say he's a film star so he can talk rubbish? He said, for example, of many things that we found last year, that DDT has been banned for use by the UN for 50 years, right? Nobody questioned it. Every newspaper even carried it. In fact, his article saying that was carried by every newspaper where you had placed that article. A junior-most reporter in my newsroom can Google DDT ban. The ban on DDT was lifted by the UN and by the US Environment Protection Agency almost 20 years ago. Not only was it lifted, but it was actually prescribed as the only effective thing for prevention of malaria and filaria, and was cleared for use inside human habitations. Right? Now, if I were to, I mean, I have a small circulation paper. If I have to write this, let me complete this, then I have to run into a celebrity, into the reach of your channels, into the fact that celebrity has 20 columns, 20 papers carrying the same column. And not just that, I have to then be painted as a corporate crony. Now, the same show, in your own wisdom, you chose to defend the issue of, defend the pesticide use. Somebody who's a very successful businessman, Mr. Shroff, Raju Shroff, but he's not the most articulate. So he spoke English in his Gujarati manner, and your anchor, the film superstar, mocked him. And as he mocked him, the crowd did ki-ki-ki-ki-ki-ki. He had no choice. He said that in California, organically grown lettuce was banned for spreading disease. Your anchor said, oh, banned for spreading disease. Oh, you believe it? Hey, the whole crowd made fun of him. Google, California lettuce organic, Google. In Germany, organic spinach has been banned because how do you grow organic? You use dung, you use human refuse, it leads to salmonella. You eat it presuming that it's clean, but it has salmonella. There's a salmonella outbreak all over California. There have been repeated salmonella outbreaks in Germany. Now, is this, Amir called me and he said, why is your paper attacking me? I said, no, we are questioning you on fact. We question bullshit no matter where it comes from. He said, I trust my research team. I said, I trust my reporters plus Google, right? Go to the UN website, go to EPA. But he's not to be confused with facts because he's a superstar. And I have limited voice because he's on your channels. And I don't even have a letter to editor on your channel. Are you people doing journalism or activism? Are you spreading falsehoods using a superstar, right, to which there is no recourse? Let me, now that we are on this, your anchor, again a superstar, his program on generic drugs. The generics versus, and many people in pharma industry here, they never speak out because every Indian businessman is so scared. The problem with Indian corporates is they're all starry-eyed and weak-kneed, right? They'll walk the golf course with dim-witted anchors who have never lifted a golf club in their lives and talk about this and that, and then they will pay money to get advertiser-paid content in our papers, including to get the weddings covered, but they'll never speak on principle. Now, generics versus branded drugs is a very serious debate. Your anchor said, if you have diabetes, don't have this drug, it's very expensive, have this drug. If you have a cold, don't have cetirizine, because that's expensive. Have this one, it's the same generic. These are printed articles, I'll mail them to you, it's a crime. Now, millions of people will say, oh, mere ko zukam ho gaya. Most people for a cold don't need any medication. Main ye dawai kha raha hu kyunki Amber Khan ne bola tha. So,
Uday, before you respond, you know, Shekhar has given a way forward for all corporates who wonder about, you know, this media activism. Whenever next time an anchor asks you questions, always ask him counter questions.
Correct.
It's the best way to put the anchor on the defensive.
This is very much in the activism. There is no anchor. Uday and I can have an argument anytime.
No, we can have an argument. And
have our respective employers to pay us for it.
No, my employer pays me without having an argument with you and pays me very well, actually. You just acknowledge that in the beginning. Two things. First of all, I hold no, I never at the beginning of Satyamev Jayate, any episode of it, or now, I never lay any claims that we do not make any mistakes in the show. In as much as the Indian Express often makes mistake in pursuit of good journalism, when we create content, sometimes we
but
make
we give
mistake.
You redressal, no?
Yeah, yeah. So we
what's my redressal?
Listen, you were waiting for CII to invite you and make this point. You could have written with to you. Me, and we could have, you know, you and I meet once a week.
No. That's wrong. I dispute it. It's been published in my paper. You could have responded.
So listen, I
do nothing in secret.
No. So that's exactly the point
you
I'm
just
making.
Sit back.
But that said, first of all, as far as Satyamev Jayate is concerned, we said many things, and I'm sure in every episode of Satyamev Jayate, we would have made some mistakes here and there. However, as far as the drugs are concerned, we never recommended to people because we were very conscious. You know, just because we are not a news company, we have to be very careful about what we say. And hence, we had a team of lawyers who just went through everything. What are the areas where we did not want to make specific recommendation. On generics, the point was very simple, that there is usually the generic drugs are cheaper, and our appeal was to various state governments and the central government that we should encourage generics so that the medical bill of people can come down. That's all. But let's debate.
I'll mail you the article. Ahmed's article.
Sure.
And when he called me, when he called me, his question was, why are you against us? So it's the same question the politicians ask you. If you question them, why are you against us?
I don't know what he meant, whether he meant against him and Kiran or against him and the film industry.
Maybe, I don't know.
It wasn't about you and me, because I never suspected that you were against me.
But let me again raise a... You said you had a bunch of lawyers clear it. You don't need lawyers for this, you need editors.
No.
That's the difference between activism and active journalism.
Yeah, Shekhar.
You can't do journalism with lawyers as your editors.
No, I'm just saying in terms of being steering clear of what we should not say. Because prescribing medicine on a show is legally an offense.
It
and
is
that's
illegal.
Why we would not... Exactly.
In
that's
a civilized country, you guys
Let's
would go to
Let's move on from Satyamev Jayate. I know, thank you for giving all the publicity to Satyamev Jayate.
But Uday, you now know why Arun and I were discussing why you actually have these TV shows where there are 8 guys who are given 30 seconds each to speak. Correct. And we were both wondering why the hell they actually come on the channel time after time. They get 30 seconds each. So you have 2 guys. If Shekhar and you today had a debate on TV, Arun and I would be in a box nodding our heads for about 45 minutes. It would be called a big debate or whatever it is.
Many people walked up to me and said that they have been to your shows and have come back without getting 2 words sideways.
No, they said,
give Rajdeep a taste of his own medicine.
You cannot pass the sins of people. You cannot pass the sins of people I have trained onto me. That's not going to work. Those are their sins.
Let me add on to this. When you talk of responsibility, it's not responsibility in only revelation. Responsibility by omission. Let me give you one great example. There's a redhead lady in London who handled a press channel, a news channel, a news group, which I believe also reports to the same boss,
yes.
Who created a lot of disturbance with PM and all that in London. We all know the story. News of the World. After that, a commission was set up by an English Lord Justice who brought out a voluminous English report which is completely unreadable. Having said that, it made very sharp recommendations, and all over the world, Lord Leveson's report has been the touchstone, has been a point of discussion all over the world. I say that with certain responsibility. In India, it was blacked out. Almost blacked out. Nobody has heard of Lord Leveson. Very few people have heard of Lord Leveson. They've heard of the redhead lady and her proximity to Prime Minister and stuff like that. It keeps happening in all countries. But the Leveson report, which lays down code on responsibility, on many other things, has never been discussed. This is not consensus. It's a conspiracy of silence. Let's face facts. Now, when you talk of 400 channels, I'll give you the actual Sarkari figure. It's 868.
No, news
licensed.
News channel.
It is a little less than 400. Now, rays of hope rather than articulate only on despair. One thing is that all our channels are competitive. They go in for competitive sensationalism because footage costs money. It costs money to him. He has deep pockets. It costs money to me. I have no pockets. But never mind. This footage I can offer, we can go in for a footage exchange. That cuts down on competition, so everybody gets it a little cheaper. You put it, we uplink it into a footage exchange and keep doing it. So you don't have to repeat the same hash again and again and again. So that's one offer that I've been making to NBA for a long time. The second is the responsibility comes as determined responsibility. You have in a particular state a Sun TV, in another you have a Moon TV. I'm not talking Star TV. Sun, Moon, whatever. They have come with political agenda. So where's the question of responsibility? I mean, responsibility is antithetical to their agenda. So we'll never get responsibility there because they're committed. Question of corporate houses taking over. Arun Puri raised this very interesting issue. That is another thing that needs to bother civil society, irrespective of whether what pockets and what salaries they get. Incidentally, when you said your employer pays you well, I was tempted to tell you that my employer pays me 75,000 rupees. But anyway, never mind. So we go on. As I put it, one is to go in for a lowering of costs so that you don't have to rehash the same thing and excite the same thing again and again. Think over it. You lead the pack. Second is forget about political channels. They are committed. Third is let's open up not only to the critical of the government. There's a lot to be critical about the government. I've been on that side, I know. But let's also open up to the wider world. Why didn't we discuss the Leveson report? We can say it's an attack on the press, but at least you have a point of view. Now, I'd end by saying that I was just noticing there are 1, 2, 3, 4 very active journalists or media persons. You four are capable of saying whatever you have said because you are not yet MPs. Thank you.
No, our ambitions are slightly higher, so we'll talk about that later. And that's why we are waiting for our time. But thank you very much for that. But very quickly, I just want to go back to the original question. And let me just frame it somewhat differently, you know, taking a cue from what Rajdeep said. Shekhar, I'll start with you. Would you rather have a very responsible media, which is not activist at all?
I would like to have a very responsible, very active media, a bulldog media, but one that checks facts. And not less, as William Sapphire once said, publishes a story about Oliver North because he said he heard Colonel East says to Colonel West and went to Colonel South to check it. That is wrong.
Arun.
You know, I want to give an example on a more serious note, is the fact that if you look at coverage of, say, communal violence, sectarian violence in this country, how delicately the media covers it. It follows very carefully, not mentioning community names. You know, it makes so ridiculous stories, but, you know, one community did this to another community, blah, blah, blah. But they're responsible because they know the consequences of carrying something like this in a place like India can lead to more violence very quickly. Rumors will spread. And I think that this is a touchstone for me in terms of at least mainstream media, in terms of how responsible they are in a very delicate area. I don't know, in today's digital world, the social media and how the digital media is going to react in these kind of situations, and can we have seen even in Muzaffarnagar and so forth, where all kinds of rumors spread so quickly and lead to all kinds of consequences. But I would say that mainstream media is responsible in the way it behaves. Yes, it can be aggressive and it can be responsible. It means better monitoring from the media companies in terms of how they run their organizations. It means editors and proprietors not having agendas, but just sticking true to the profession. So I think definitely they can be active and they can be responsible.
Thanks. Rajdeep?
You know, I've always believed in most aspects of this country, we are what I call a 50-50 country. And that is as true of the media as it is true of most institutions. So you will have good, solid journalism that is still done, and you have bad, sensationalist journalism that is also being done. And I hope over a long period of time, and you know, the problem is we tend to measure this in terms of TRPs every week on week as if it's box office. But I think over an extended period of time, I've always believed you can easily separate the good from the bad. So, I mean, I remain deeply optimistic, Uday. When I look at where I, when I joined this profession 25 years ago and a bit and compare it with today, I mean, in many ways, the media today is far more vibrant and diverse than we were 25 years ago. I see it even in regional media, which for a long time was particularly cowed down by, you know, this so-called English elite media. I see vibrancy there as well. You know, I think we are all going to have to learn to live with this beast. The problem, and you know, this comes to the original question perhaps which has been posed before this audience, is that I think we all have to start realizing the government unleashed a beast in this country. And I'm looking at television 24/7, 20 years ago. And now, once you've unleashed a man-eating animal into the jungle, now to tame it is not going to happen. So if the answer to can activist media be responsible is please tame this media, that's not going to happen. I think the answer is in a lot of what the others have said. Arun and Shekhar in particular have said that I think what you need is better quality media. I think once you have better quality, all these other issues will be sorted out. I think how do we build quality media is really the challenge of our times. Can we invest? Can we build an Al Jazeera kind of channel? Can we, you know, invest like a CNN can on a big story? Unless we can change our business model to invest, to mentor young journalists, I think these questions will continue to haunt us.
I would like to say that overall, if you look at it, that media, especially with this 24, imagine a world firstly now in India without 24-hour news channels. I don't think you can think about it. But if you look at it as a whole, media has done good for the society. It has done enormous good to the society. It has made politicians far more accountable, far more transparent. They can't get away with anything. There's constant, I mean, many politicians call me up, okay, you ran the story once, why do you keep running it all day, right? But, you know, people don't watch a news channel, they come in any time. They don't understand the fact that people may watch a news channel at any time, so the story goes on 24 hours. So this constant scrutiny by the media has done enormous good to this society, I think.
Thanks.